Wagwan, good people. It's the Midnight Hump Show. Thank you so much for tuning in from all around the world. It's about to get crazy with...
Brought to Cruise of the Cocoa Master.
So my name is Shirley Hero. What a one blah.
It's your girl, LED Zone.
Wagwan, good fam. On today's show, we have Bonkerz coming through for What the Fashion, guest DJ Chelsea Vancart, and guest hosting on today's show is Eleanor and Nadia. Get ready, this is the Midnight Hump Show. Wagwan, good fam. My name is Brad Jacuzzi, and this is the Midnight Hump Show, episode 28 of season 2. Oh my gosh. And right now, you know, I don't have Elodie Zone nor Shiro, but I do have some extremely vibrant young ladies in the building, some university gals. We have the one and only Eleanor and Nadia.
Hello.
What's up,
not
y'all?
To forget DJ Chelsea Vancart. Well, it's just Chelsea Vancart. Yeah, no DJ. She said, look, I'm Chelsea Vancart, the DJ.
The producer.
Just that. How you all doing? Thank y'all for coming.
We are good. How are you?
Hey, I'm good. You know, I liked you guys, you know, before we had met, like that other time, but now I don't really like you guys too much. Because they've been messing with me.
Because he found out his real name. That's why he hates us. We know his real name.
Barack Jacuzzi.
Hey, you better put those fingers away.
Jacuzzi.
Hey, look, that is my real name. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Hey, but good fam. How you guys doing?
Thank you so much for having us.
You're welcome. You know, Elodie's in France. She's out there doing French stuff, eating French toast.
Croissants.
Spaghetti.
Sacre bleu. You know, spaghetti, noodles.
Spaghetti's Italian, no?
It's in Europe, right?
And he's like, noodles.
It's in Europe.
You think she's eating indomie in Paris?
I'm just saying, though, it's in the same general location, man. I didn't say fufu and mugari. Okay. That's like the same thing. But before we get this show on the road, we gotta big up the people that watch the show. The ones that are cooler than you guys, because you know they don't know a lot about me. And I'm gonna start really
I'm Jacuzzi.
Really, look, y'all are testing me. Every time y'all start saying my name, I'm really getting scared. But it is Barack Jacuzzi, guys. Okay? Hey, would you like to go first?
Big up to Khalid Spitzy.
Couch Spixy, whoa.
Thank you for watching.
Whoa, you sound real majestic. You know what I mean?
So majestic.
Something else. Spixy.
Couch. Goddamn.
Or Game of Thrones. Lord Spixy. All right, hey, shout out to Brian Kuria. Wagwan, my
G. He's probably my relative. Kuria.
Hey, Kuria. That's everybody's relative, though, man. I got a couple of those. uncles.
Okay, thank you, Jael Wangila, for watching the show.
Wangila, what it do, though?
What up?
Onika Joix? Is it Joix?
Is that fancy name?
What's up with all these X's?
Joix.
You know
what I'm saying? Joix.
It's the X.
You never see some X in our name.
You never see X's in
a
name.
But we got too many X's already.
Oh, you did it.
I mean.
Round of applause. And last but not least, 2for1.co.ke. I'm glad y'all are rocking with us. I guess that's a company y'all must be liking our stuff.
I know.
Because you know where we get these names, just from people that are like either liking or commenting, either on YouTube, or it could be from any platform. So if you guys want to get big up, you just gotta holler at us on any of our social networks. You can holler at us on WGNetworks.tv. That is the motherboard. And from there, you can get us on Twitter at What's Good Live, on Facebook at What's Good _ Live, on Instagram at WGLive.tv. And is there any more? Oh, Snapchat, What's Good Live. You need to follow us on Snapchat. That's all y'all been doing. I see where y'all's battery life.
Don't be hating because you have the kabamba now. Don't.
Why you had to put me on blast,
like you're talking about all your social media, but social media. Really?
All right, look, I had a tough Sunday night.
Do you really have social media?
Do you really?
On your techno?
Kick a man when he's down. That's what we're doing now. That's what it is.
It's all love.
Okay, you know, I see this is going to be a long show. Let's just mosey right along to Ratchet News. You know, this is one of my favorite parts of the show because ain't nothing better than some news that's a little bit ratchet. Ain't nothing better than stuff that's ratchet. You know, I always like things that are just a little bit ratchet, you know?
You have to get a little bit ratchet.
Like, I like a girl that's a good girl, but she's a little bit ratchet.
Halal in the streets.
You know?
Haram in the streets.
Haram in the streets.
cheese.
Hey, who said that? But this is what I'm working with, guys. So just don't WhatsApp me, all right? Like, text
don't
me, y'all.
Don't Snapchat him.
Give me a
None
call.
Of that.
Give me a
None
call.
Of that. Text no message. No SMS.
Man, y'all some haters, man. Y'all some haters. Who signed them up to come into this show today?
You did.
Damn, that's right.
Barack Jacuzzi.
Once again, putting me on blast. All right, we're going to stop this quotation mark, all right, with my name. We're stopping that right now. My name is Barack
Jacuzzi.
Let's get to this ratchet news. So, I don't know if y'all heard about this, but in New Mexico, there's a story about a man, or a son and a mother who have had relations, you know, intimate relations. And I didn't know you. I think somebody was telling me that he was adopted. It was you. Yeah. So he was adopted when he was 7. So he got taken away from her, and I guess they linked back up. And now, you know, they getting it popping.
No.
Yeah, it's real. And I have a quote, you know. Monica, she's 36 and her son's 19. So that means she had him when she was like, what, 15?
Yeah.
That's not a big gap. That's not that bad of a gap. But it's your son. So, you know, you got no excuse. But she says, at first it kind of felt weird, but now it doesn't feel that weird to me because I love him so much.
Okay, so I actually also watched this video.
Obsessed.
I'm not sure if it was 7, but then, like, when they were being interviewed, like, the son was talking about it, and he's like, you know, I met my mom for the first time, and, you know, we just had this connection, like, everything was so real, and I just had to kiss her at the moment that I saw her, so, like, they kissed, and, you know.
That
like,
is disgusting. Yeah. No. There's no woman there. That's nasty. That's your mom. I don't care if you're adopted or anything. That's your mom.
No,
we're both talking about it, you know. Like, even the mom was like, you know, I know it's not right, but, like, I feel something different about him. You know, he's so handsome. He looks so much like his
How
dad.
How many people like, are there in the world? Like, did you really have to fall in love with your mother? Or your son? Like, no.
Like, that's your son.
That's disgusting. Oh, goddamn.
So, you guys were never, like,
come on.
Hit a poppin' with
your son. Barack Jacuzzi.
I'm just trying to see what y'all are into. I know, you know, college girls these days, they down for whatever, you know what I mean?
No, not that. Not that.
I mean,
that.
I don't think there is a line. Is in the incest bracket. Like, there's whatever, like, we're down for whatever, but, like, incest
there's
is
some
like,
things, like, that is against.
They're down for some crazy stuff.
That like, is literally, incest is against every that's Game of Thrones. Religion. Yeah, it's against every religion.
That's King Joffrey right
God
there.
No.
That's King Joffrey.
It's wrong at the end of the day, and it's disgusting.
You know, guys, let's try not to, you know, have some incest going on. Let's try to keep that out of the world. You know, there's enough. We got Donald Trump.
I don't think
there's enough people to fall in love with in the world than your parents or your family. For just sure. Cousins, nothing. There's enough people in the world for everyone.
I mean, do you guys think, like, you would be better off falling in love with your mom?
No,
wait, can you just wait?
You said mom. Nope.
You think you
that is true. That does totally disqualify.
Yeah, like, you already said mom. You already said mom.
I mean, maybe in terms of what we've already discussed.
Okay,
like,
okay,
you think he would be better off falling in love with his mom or, like, with his sisters or his cousins or something?
Nah.
Okay, either way, they're still family members. I don't care whether it's your cousin, your mother, your fifth cousin. It's disgusting and it's incest.
He needs to go get a nice girl that he's not related to.
His own age.
Find someone, get involved in a church.
That you're not related to.
You will find some good girls during Bible service.
That you're not related to.
Thank you. It's disgusting.
So, do you guys have any ratchet news?
So apparently there are these guys in Yeri who went to steal coffee.
Oh yeah, the coffee robbers.
10 million worth of coffee. But in the midst of them stealing all this coffee, they decided, you know what, we need to have a meal. So they went
like, we hungry.
Yeah, like, we hungry. They were like 30 guys. They went and stole chickens plus rice. Cooked the whole meal in the timber. In the
factory?
Yeah, in the factory. Thank you.
Timber, what was...
I don't know. I was going to say timber mill.
Okay.
But yeah, they cooked the whole meal and then proceeded to eat all of it while the watchmen, they stripped them down ass naked.
So they came 30 deep.
Yeah.
And
they were stripped naked and tied
to poles.
They
sold 10 million worth of coffee.
They didn't get caught.
No.
They must have been pretty accurate, though.
They got it. They got it. They got that. Go away with it. Like, and plus a meal.
So...
pasta meal.
They must have been pretty accurate.
And they literally cooked the whole meal. Like, I don't know how they had time to start finding, like,
39 chickens,
the 39 chickens, and then they made rice. Like, they had a whole meal, and they were like, you know what?
That's
like,
so yes, random,
we have
though.
Stolen. We have like, eaten. Our day is done. Like, we got it.
But they got away, right?
They got away.
And they haven't been captured or caught?
Nope.
Nada.
Dang, you guys, you know, y'all are best friends. First of all, for those who don't know, these guys are best friends. That's why they're having such a great time on me over here, sitting by my lonely.
Just ganging up on him.
Well, for those who don't know, you guys, what do you guys do? You know, you guys are in school, but what else do you dibble dabble in?
School.
Yeah,
I mean, what that? Majors? I mean,
I'm studying PR.
Okay.
Yes, public relations.
I'm studying computer science.
But y'all are planning on y'all dibble dabble, because you know these guys, they're working on a show, you know, behind the scenes. I ain't gonna give you too many details,
not
but
too
you know,
many,
you
not
know,
many.
They play their cards right, they play their cards right, you know, and it might smell good as well. It is, you know,
it is smelling good.
Are y'all good cooks? Can y'all cook?
Okay,
yes, we can.
You know,
what
we
you
can,
mean? Okay,
we can hold it down, we can hold it.
Somebody put some. Thank you, okay. Chelsea.
Let me just talk about something. Since Chelsea wanted to go there, the other day we were at Chelsea's house. It was 4 a.m. She was crying. She's like, Eleanor, please cook for me. I'm like, no, Chelsea, no.
Yeah, I don't recall
I can't.
That.
I'm like, no, you know, like, see, I'm so sleepy. She's like, no, Eleanor, please cook for me. Like, you know, you're the only one in this house who can cook. Thank you. I don't have to say anything else other than that. Other than... Eleanor, you're the only one in this house who can cook.
Look,
and it says so much that Chelsea is the one who had to say that I don't cook. So she knows that I can cook, but okay.
We're gonna put you on the Midnight Hump Show trial right now. Now, and she said that you said that she's the only one who can cook.
She
now,
said that.
Did you say those words?
I don't recall saying.
And you know what?
That.
The funny thing is, even though she's denying it, I still, you know what? I still cooked for her after all that.
Okay, she can cook. She can cook.
I was like, yeah, that's what I thought
too.
You
can cook. Don't worry.
Yeah, because you want me to cook for you the next time.
Yeah, I'm a beast in the kitchen.
Okay,
really?
I can cook. What do you want me to name stuff? What am I on trial? It's not about me and cooking. Look, I can microwave.
Okay. You dig popcorn? You good?
I can microwave anything.
What?
I just need power and a microwave. I can't cook, guys.
Thank you.
Is that what y'all wanted me to say?
But you know what? Let me just say this. Even Nadia makes a killer breakfast.
I make breakfast.
Pancakes. Eggs, bacon, you know.
Yeah.
I'm a beast with the breakfast. Toast.
You know, what do you want? Coffee?
Butter.
I got you.
We got it.
Nadia makes
a killer breakfast, but like, you know, a simple rice or something.
Okay, I can cook meat though. Like, give me meat.
Like, you talking about meat that's
you.
Like chewy or like.
No. Proper food. Like, I can make you proper food. Tell me, bring me chicken. I'll make you good chicken. All right, trust me.
We gonna find out. You know, we gonna find
out. She has to read that recipe first.
Recipe or no recipe? Did you die though?
No, I didn't know you could read. That's amazing.
Okay, so you're just salty because I have a smartphone and you...
Hey, we're going to go to the next segment, guys, because it's getting kind of hot in here.
Okay.
Or salty in here.
Too salty.
Now, did y'all see the update on Instagram with Snapgram?
Mm-mm. Oh, yeah. Snapgram? Oh, now you can take it. I hate it.
You don't like it?
No.
You don't like it?
It's just too much.
It's
like,
too
okay,
extra.
I don't... Okay, to all my followers on Instagram, like, I love y'all, but like... I don't want to see everyone's stuff who follows me on
That's
Instagram.
That's true, though. Like, the first 2 days, I was really on it. Then I was like, what am I doing here?
And already, I feel like if I have Snapchat, things I'm going to post on my Snap story and the same things I'm going to post on Instagram. So it doesn't make sense. Like, everyone would be so annoyed. Like, I've already seen this. Stop.
And then there's so many people who on my Snap, like, I'll see them, like...
And then on the Instagram,
it's
like,
on the same thing, huh?
Like, I'm like, okay, guys, I already saw this. I
think y'all are gonna like this. Then we're gonna show y'all a skit of the death of Snapchat because the numbers on Snapgram have really been going up. So Snapchat's kind of suffered, but I think that was just for like the first week. So I want y'all to check out this skit of the death of Snapchat. And coming up next, we're going to get into a quick love and lust segment where I go head to head with these two ladies on some boys versus girl topics. I don't care if it's more than y'all and me. So keep it locked to the Midnight Hump Show. We right here.
Whew, I've never felt better. You know, life is great.
I thought we had something special. I thought it was you and me, me and you, forever. But no, y'all on that new, huh?
I mean, why can't everybody be like me? So chill, so cool, you know? I got no problems, no issues, no delays. I got all the filters. You know, 1, 2, 3, I got them.
He looked just like me. He talked just like me. He does everything just like me. But y'all ain't got no love for Snapchat no more. That's what it is, huh? That's what we doing now. Taking all my friends. People don't even want to chill no more. They just...
I got everything. There's no need to look anywhere else. You're looking right here. Look at me. Look at me, baby. So original.
They don't rock with Snapchat now? Snapchat's not cool? All the snaps we done did? All the hours we done used accumulated? I can't believe this. But, you know, whatever. It's whatever, I'm cool. I'm cool. Can I have some strep suits?
Bing, bam, boom, bam, bing, bam, boom, bop, or bam. I don't know where I was going with that one. I was like, how should I come back into this one? And it just came to me. Hey, but we're back at it like crack addicts. Ooh, having back spasms. Oh, that was...
You did it! That's
double entendre. That was terrible. Here we go. So, you know, I feel like we've been building up a nice beef relationship this episode of The Hump Show.
Are you really ready for the drama, though?
Nah, I've been ready. My name's Roger Cousy, man. I've been bubbling, okay. Girl.
Hey, That's what he says.
You guys. You tell some people a couple letters of difference, you know what I mean? And they just... Y'all like, Drake, man, get up off me. So, we're going to pull up some memes on the screen, and they really go against stereotypes that go between boys and girls. And we're going to, you know, see if, you know, they're true, and, you know, see if they're wrong. If we could throw up the first one, boys, girls. Oh, that's so true. That's 100% true. I mean, I think they're saying that girls are more organized than guys.
We definitely are. Definitely.
I'm gonna have to take an L on that one. I'm gonna have to take. I mean, boys are like. There's some guys that are organized.
I don't even feel like we should be having this conversation. Like, wow. Is it really necessary? Wow. I mean, it's obvious. Girls are more organized.
The disrespect. Like, the disrespect.
It's not even disrespect. It's the truth.
Look,
it's the truth. You need to know the difference between disrespect and plain truth.
Yeah.
I know I'm a mess, and I'm the only guy in here who, you know, can speak for the guys, and I'm a mess. So for this one, personally speaking, not on the behalf of all guys, but for this one in the room, you guys got that.
Are you
got
personally that W. messy?
Very.
I mean, you can see it, like...
And you're the one who's supposed to be helping the guys today. You're
man,
failing.
I'm just saying, like, you gotta be honest, man. You're getting failing. My future on. Can we go to the next one? I've met some messy girls, though. Don't get it twisted. Boys... So what are they saying, that guys get cheap haircuts and girls spend
that's
a lot of money?
That's also so true.
That's that very true. But yeah. For a guy with long hair, I do spend a little pretty penny sometimes.
Yeah,
you know, so.
But I don't think it will ever come
to what,
like,
girls,
to what
spend.
Girls. Like, I mean, if you look at like something like the way Vera had that, or not even Vera, like if you look at Nyola Creative, like there's weaves in that place for 100,000 shillings. Like,
yeah.
I mean, I'm never
which
gonna
guy
see
is
a
gonna
boy
get a
spending
haircut
all that money.
More,
like,
no.
Which hello?
Guy will spend more than like at least 5 G's, and even that's putting the bar way high.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, yeah, who's gonna spend more than 5,000 on
we
a
ain't,
haircut?
We ain't with that.
Or doing the hair, yeah.
We ain't with
but
that
a girl.
At all.
ready to even spend half a mil on their hair.
Everyone is always telling us, like, your hair is your crown.
Yeah, so your hair is your crown. Literally, you have to love it.
So I guess you take the L on that as well. That is also, that's a true one. Can we go to the next one? Can I get a good one? All right, respect, honor, love, care, girl, impress, smile, game over. Ah, that's so true. Like, girls really don't have to do much to get guys.
I mean, they really don't.
Think.
Okay, no, the thing is, the difference is, you don't have to do much to get a guy, but you have to do so much to make him stay. Like,
oh, yeah, to
there's
keep
all
him.
These Whoa. Other girls who are going to smile at him.
Thank you.
I mean, come on.
Ladies, did you hear that one? Say it again. That was a good
Shout
one.
Shout out.
But no, for real, like,
back.
it's so easy to smile at a boy,
but it's
you know,
so
you feel like you have it,
in.
But I mean, another girl 5 minutes later is gonna come
and
flash
also,
the
like,
same smile
what
that
are the
you just
chances
flashed,
of you,
and you're just like, okay.
And also, what are the chances of you walking up to a guy and be like, oh, hi, this is my name, and the chances of guys coming to you, you know?
Yeah.
Like, by the time I walk up to you and say hi to you, oh, trust me, honey.
It's hard.
Honey.
It's hard.
It's too hard.
That's true.
It's
I mean, especially keeping a guy.
Guys will always come to you. Even if you
Always.
Don't smile at them, they're just
even
there.
If you're ugly, like not
oh
even
gosh.
I mean, like boys in this
it's
day
true,
and age are gonna hit on anything.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
Like, you don't need to do
that's
much. Literally,
true.
All you need to do is smile. So
or
the difference is, yeah,
breathe.
Just be if you're
or
fully
blink.
If you're fully
just
functional
blink.
Right now, like you're pretty much in the game.
Yeah.
Let's see the next one. And we can make this one the last one before
oh
we get into the next
god.
Segment. Oh, this is so true. We got one.
Oh my god.
It's so true. Girls can never keep nothing to themselves. This is how it goes exactly. This is such an
okay,
accurate.
No, the issue is exactly this. Don't tell anyone. It's like, I'll tell her. Like, don't tell anyone. And then she'll go and tell the next person. Don't tell anyone. And everyone just keeps being told, don't tell anyone. Don't tell anyone. Don't tell anyone. And nothing ever sticks.
But I mean, I feel like the difference is, like, the boys will be like, don't tell anyone, because to their boys, they're embarrassed of whatever
yeah,
that's
true.
Going on between
nah,
them and the
nah,
girls. But with the girls, it's just like, yeah, that's what he did. He took
nah.
me for lunch.
Yeah,
oh,
he
yeah.
did this. But a boy never knows.
He's just like,
to know,
I
like,
took
like,
up
oh,
a lunch.
Wait.
Don't tell anyone.
Like, don't, like, he won't even tell. You can go on a date with a guy and he won't even tell one friend, even his best friend.
That's true.
Even
like,
yeah.
And like, this
like,
girl
don't
was tell just
anyone.
So happy. Like, oh my god. He took me for lunch. Oh my god. So
Nadia will tell me and I'll be like, Nadia, oh my gosh, can you believe Nadia went on a date with a guy? And she'll be like, wow, let me tell you who.
That's true though.
I don't know, went on a date. Like, someone, like.
Yeah.
That's very true.
But
I do.
Never
I do.
Be
I silently go on dates all the time. Don't tell a soul.
Oh, wow.
That's I mean, all of you girls who have gone out with Barack and
no,
feel like you are special. Ha!
No,
I'm sorry.
You ain't.
Hey, Chelsea, good to see you.
Good to see you too,
it's
man.
Great to have you here. You know, great to have you here.
I really feel bad. These guys are on your
yeah, what's
so
good? What do you feel like? Do you feel like this is true though? That girls
kinda
I mean,
like I know some boys who talk more than my girlfriends.
Or,
like they gossip so much. I'm just like
niggas talk.
But you know, niggas talk
exactly.
Exactly.
Now boys talk, but most of the time, like even if we talk in a big group,
it's
like,
a lie.
That's the difference.
It's a lie. Listen,
if we talk in a big group, like nobody tells anybody. You know, like maybe this will be all of us together. This is all separated.
Me, I feel like the difference is if a girl, like this whole pyramid, this hierarchy.
It's very true though. This is extremely accurate.
If the boys had the same hierarchy, it would all be a lie. Like, it would start from Barack went on a date, and then Barack smashed this chick, and then
yeah,
Barack just smashed
you.
This
Could
chick
we
and
use
her
a
best
different
friend.
Example?
Barack, like, come, okay, sorry, Barack.
Thank you.
Barack.
Oh, you scared people will know.
Y'all are so wrong. Can we go to the next slide? Boys. Oh my gosh, this is very accurate.
Like, so accurate.
Sick. No lie.
Cars.
So accurate.
This is very accurate.
That's accurate.
But I mean,
we're still ahead.
Yeah,
like,
I mean.
Girls rock.
Let's go to the next one. We got two. Tell me.
Barack, I read this thing about men. All men don't cheat. Some of y'all chicks just assume you're in a relationship.
Ooh.
The Lord said that.
Yeah, that's very true. The Lord told me that too.
But I mean, let me tell you, I feel like for a girl to ever feel like she's in a relationship with you, you have to genuinely have led her there. Like girls overthink everything. Yeah,
Boys
girls overthink everything.
Why are you shouting at the microphone? What did the mic do to you?
Maybe it's a male.
It's a male mic. That's the issue.
Maybe it reminds you of some male things, but this is a unisex mic.
This big? I don't know.
This is a unisex mic, all right? So let's not bring the mic into this.
No, I feel like at the end of the day, like, there's nothing like, oh, she thought we were in a relationship. Like, boys
would always like to make her
think that. Oh, you're my baby. Oh, I love you. Nah, but, this.
Nah, that's true. But sometimes girls be wild.
No, but sometimes girls are crazy.
Okay, yeah, for sure.
They cuckoo, you know what I mean? They loco with the cocos.
They're crazy. Like, I've met so many girls who will genuinely have been like, yeah, that's my boyfriend. But then I know him personally. And it's just like,
no, we went out once. Like, that's it. And we, like, maybe I texted her twice or thrice. That's it.
Y'all ever been that crazy girl that thought y'all was with somebody, but y'all really wasn't?
No. To make sure down to a T.
For sure. Keep
we in this or what?
We got it.
Communication.
We in this or what?
Communication is key.
It's the major key.
Are we done or is there another one?
Oh,
another one after y'all said major key.
Another one.
Is this the last one? When a boy proposes, a girl. When a girl proposes, I love you. Oh yeah, this is so true. Not for like, you know, the Coco Master, but this is true for the average. Yeah, but we just met. Like, I mean, I think this is more of a high school thing. I don't know.
It is.
Yeah, I think it's more of a high school thing. But you know, girl, this is definitely true. Guys say yeah to whatever.
I feel like even if the guy has just met you and you propose to him and you're like, let's go, programmed to lie to women and just to please her. Like, you'll say anything to please her, so you'll just be like, okay, let's get married.
And it's crazy, like, men
are programmed to lie.
Like, their brains are like wired to know what exactly to say to girls, and it's so sad.
It's so sad.
Some girls out there are so naive and they literally don't know that. So, like, I'll be listening to someone's story and I'll be like, Tell me more.
Yo, you're gonna hurt your daughter's feelings. Your daughter's gonna come home with a story. She's gonna be like, honey, he is no good.
No, I'm telling her straight. You're talking to me about a boy. Tell me what he did. You're stupid.
No, like, you're dumb.
Like, don't be dumb. Don't be dumb. These men are programmed to lie to us.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Hey, Kabambe Swada.
Hey, my Kibambe is popping. What can I say, man?
As he says, Kibambe.
What can I say? What is this? What is it?
Kabambe.
Kabambe.
Yeah. Kabambe.
So it's not key?
Ka.
So you sure it's not, a key?
You know, you don't understand that, like, Kabambe people are troopers.
Kabambe.
I mean, you have to be on that swag. You don't even know what
Kabambe.
You're a real trooper.
Hey, whatever's clever. Tomato, tomato. Potato, potato. More juice.
You got
it. Come on. Listen, I think this is the last one. When a boy likes video games, girls be hating.
No.
But when girls like video games, we do love a gamer.
No. I mean,
okay, personally, I really like FIFA and like Mortal Kombat and I don't know, like,
give
I like specific
games. I wanna shoot you.
Yeah, but
that's what's up.
But I mean, generally some girls don't like when people are playing FIFA, they'll just be like,
yeah, they get annoyed, like
Muzzle combat.
I think it's something that you just have to get accustomed to.
I think it's an attention thing. Like, you know, they want the
attention. Like, oh, you're just playing that game.
Yeah. It is an attention thing.
I mean,
I'm fine with a guy playing FIFA,
not for 2 hours.
Not even 2 hours. 1 hour. Like, I mean,
I feel like the first hour I'd also be playing, so it's just like
2 hours is like solid.
No, a game of FIFA.
You can't just play one. I mean, come on.
You see, now
you're just gonna have one potato chip? No. Come on, you gotta have a couple.
I feel like my maximum is like 5 games, and then don't expect me to just be sitting there the whole
time watching you.
I can't even pitch into the conversation. I don't know anything about football, so I can't even
pitch. She really got the juice. She'll get them off the sticks.
Yo,
you know what I mean?
You know what it is.
She really got the juice. She'll get them off the sticks, and y'all know it too. Hey, I think that was like a tie for Love and Lust, Boys vs. Girls.
It's not like 6-1.
Come on. Y'all.
6-1 or 6-0.
Y'all scraping points off the board, man. I had like a good 2 wins.
I'm sorry. Boys always
maybe
lose,
one.
Y'all always think you're winning, but
I know.
Nada.
Coming up next, we have My boy Edwin, you guys know him too. He used to be your neighbor. Bo, he's coming through. He's the creator of Bonkerz. He's gonna sit with us, talk to us, tell us about his clothing line, all the new clothes he's got coming out, the old ones, where they started from, and a lot more. These are my guest hosts for today: Eleanor, Nadia, and of course Chelsea Vancart. Keep it locked to the Midnight Hump Show and check out this Coke Studio video where Shiro went and hollered at some of the artists at Coke Studios this year. Keep it locked. This is the Midnight Hump Show.
Good people, beautiful people of the world. It's Shirley here, Reverend What's Good Live, and we're here at Stanley Hotel in the CBD of Nairobi to talk to two of the artists of Season 4 Coke Studio, Naima and Chameleon. You guys, we've got an exclusive interview, so keep it locked. This is What's Good Live. Alright, good people, I am here with the beautiful singstress, songstress, lyricist, songwriter, Naima. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Beautiful you too.
Thank you so much. Like, you're just radiating so much like good vibes and positive energy. I'm loving sitting next to you. How was your flight over from Mozambique? How did you find it?
I will speak in Portuguese.
Yes.
I will teach you.
Please.
Obrigado. I love Portuguese.
O voo foi ótimo.
The flight was perfect.
Amazing.
Yeah, it was amazing.
I'm just loving the voice.
The act,
I don't know what you're saying, but I'm loving every single word. It's so good.
Tudo bem.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. So let's talk about music. So when did it first start? How did you know that it was your calling? And why did you decide to pursue it?
Mm-hmm. Fala de música. Como é que você decidiu começar?
Bom, a música aconteceu assim, como acontece com qualquer pessoa.
It just happened as it happened with anyone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cantar, em casa, dançar, participar em concursos de dança, de música, surgiu exatamente assim.
Yeah. Singing at home, yeah, watching people dancing at home, yeah. So I participated in some shows and stuff, yeah.
Ficava a assistir o Michael Jackson na televisão e eu dizia que eu quero ser como o Michael.
Yeah, she used to watch Michael Jackson in television. Uh-huh. She was just pointing like, I want to be like Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Wagwan, good people, I am here with the one and only infamous Chameleon. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
It's good to have you here. How's your journey been?
My journey has been good. Excuse me. My journey has been good. Everything is good. I mean, when I'm in Kenya, when I'm in Nairobi, I'm home. So don't scare me, eh? I'm home.
How have you been able to persevere and to continue to push?
Originality and originality is the biggest card that you need to be here for the 16 years I've been. And then what I feel is I don't throw up my achievements to people. I mean, whatever I've achieved is for my own happiness. I don't go bossing on people. I try to keep myself humble. So that is also very, very paramount to be able to stay around. Otherwise, people will get bored or they get disgusted about you. Be like, he's Chameleon, but he's so full of himself. He's blah, blah, blah.
In terms of music and sound, is that something that you're trying to play with when it comes to making your music?
No, I've always kept my originality. You see, I won't change my recipe because I've already been certified as a great chef.
Five stars. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, yes.
Yeah, so when you change your recipe, they'll tell you what is missing. So what I have to do is keep my originality and let some people also keep their originality together. We can take the whole body together. Yeah.
Amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Chameleon, the number one key player, motivator, magic man behind the mic. You guys, keep it locked. This is What's Good Life.
Oh yeah, more juice. Welcome back to the Midnight Hump Show. Right now we have a very special guest in the building, one of Kenya's leading brand designers, my boy Edwin. How you doing, bro?
What's good, man?
The creator of Bonkerz.
Yo, bro, know. How do you call me my government name?
Man, you know,
people don't know that name.
Yo, I found out your name was Edwin today.
I didn't know
people
either.
Don't know that name, man.
You know, I was like, you know, I asked myself, I was like, you know, like right before you came, like, I was like, do I need to know his real name? Or will he get offended? Like, you don't know my name? You know what I'm saying? You just pissing on my clothes?
No, man. Like,
and all right, the whole Bonkerz, time we were like, Mvo, Mvo. Barack is like, Mvo!
Mvo! Like, no.
Mvo. We're like, yo.
These guys are like two heads on one body. Like, can we get them one mic or something? Because I'm not with this, okay? Bonkerz, man. Look, let's jump right into this.
Sure.
Like, when I first met you, it was like 2012 over there in your USIU days.
Yeah.
We didn't really like kick it, but you know, we made eye contact normal. Now, you started off with chains, right? You started off with necklaces. That's the first time I ever saw the Bonkerz logo.
Yeah.
You started off with necklaces?
When I began the brand, at that point in time, everyone was doing t-shirt lines.
Mm-hmm.
So in a bid to be original, in a bid to be brand new, I opted to transform the animated bear into a chain instead. Because I was one of those kids back in the day who would go to the back of the source just to check out that, like, cubic zirconian diamonds and, like, them chains, because I've always been into that culture and everything. So my idea behind it is to, like, be the Tiffany's of Africa.
Hey.
That's like the goal. That's like the end game, man. So, yeah.
Now, who inspired you to get into clothes? Were you always like, you know, trying to rip up your shirts and do whatever you could to make it different, or?
So there's this funny story. I was actually like telling my housemate the other day. Back in the day, I used to have like just a limited amount of like clothes. So it got to a point you'd pull up to a spot and your homies would be like, yo, I told you the nigga would pull up in them jeans, you know?
Yeah,
so
we all know that one nigga. We all know.
So when after all that, man, I just got to a point where I just like, yo, dude, man, you have to change the face of yourself for the purpose of those like you.
So what, you were like, man, I ain't got a lot of clothes. Let me just make a clothing line for myself.
Yeah, really. Like,
oh, juice.
Like when that's I began crazy. Bonkerz, the idea behind it was for me and my niggas just to rock it and look cool.
Mm-hmm.
But it made sense to turn it into a business because people were digging it.
For sure.
In fact, I have one for you, man.
For Barack only.
For Barack. Yeah, for Barack.
Talk about no homo. Talk about
no homo. No. Like, I'll give you guys some of the new things.
Okay, okay.
We get it. No, we get it.
Yo, so that's like the Bonkerz bear.
Ah, 100.
I mean, so out of like everything that you've designed, like what piece of accessory do you think is gonna do like the best this season, or what do you like the most out of everything that you've designed?
At the moment, I'm concentrating on apparel because from October of last year, we ventured into the clothing business, branching off of the jewelry line, because for about like 2 years, I took like a space off like the whole business thing, just like figure myself out, figure out what I was trying to do. And in a sense, the chains dwindled. So now, in a sense, to rebrand myself, I came in with the clothing. So for now, I've been concentrating on upperwear, like jackets, because I've always loved jackets.
So the necklaces were the first thing that you ever designed?
Yeah, the chains were the
and
first
the bombers,
thing.
The bombers, people are loving the bombers, man. Yeah. I've been seeing them everywhere.
Not even that, I love the fact that I can send you a design of like a specific jumper I want, and I'll tell you, okay, I want less of fabric in it and whatever, and you'll make it for you, you know? Yeah. That's what I find so amazing.
Your custom is key, man.
Custom is key. Major key.
Did somebody ever tell you like, yo, you need to start doing custom, you need to start customizing, or it was just...
You see, when I began the brand, at that point in time, I was working at Red Republic, which is a recording label where Mad Trax and The Council record. So because I was around them, they needed custom things. Mm-hmm. And because I was in the business, I began to design for them. And all that grew into now branding local celebrities, where now everyone wanted like, yo, dude, could you make me a chain with my name? So I was like, yeah, dude, I could become King Custom.
You know?
King Custom.
King Custom, I like that. That's like your name.
Nice hashtag. Yeah. Got a nice hashtag, too. So now with, when is the Red Bomber Jacket coming out, man?
Oh,
I've been hitting you up about this weeks, man.
So from January, we've been on an experimentation period because I'm a perfectionist. And I want to put out the best. So we've just been trying out different silhouettes, different jacket patterns. So the Red Bomber is one of the pieces that's coming out at the end of this month, but for sure, you know, you're getting the exclusive.
For sure.
Now, quote unquote, no homo. But, you know.
Nah, they some haters, bro. Don't even worry about them, bro.
Talk to me.
I know your new, is he, I don't know if he's your new, but New Funk is doing your digital, what is he doing? Marketing? What is he doing?
So he's our new addition to the team. He's doing all our visual work, basically. So he's like the visual director for the brand, and he's just like transformed the brand
to different heights.
Like my Instagram page now is buzzing.
DMing. Shout out.
If New Funk don't trust you.
Did you actually have to wait for the Kenyan fashion industry to pick up, or were you just like, you know what, like, this is what I want to do, I'm just gonna do it right now? Yeah.
In 2012, I would say, was like the beginning of new age street style in Nairobi.
Yeah.
I mean, street style has existed from back then, where we had people like Fundi Frank, who were like the Cal Kanai of Kenya.
Yeah.
And in 2012, people began doing t-shirts. We had Epic Nation, we had Vazi, we had a couple of other people who came out at the same time. And just because of that, I've always wanted to get into the fashion business, and I was just like, yo, it's ripe now. But the crazy thing about it is Nairobi right now is buzzing.
It's booming.
Crazy, man.
It's booming. So with that being said, I mean, I guess I already know how you feel, but just elaborate a little more on how you feel like the way it's happened, the Nairobi fashion market right now and fashion scene now compared to maybe 2-3 years ago. I think it's about a full 360.
Definitely. I feel like the whack people have been sieved out.
Yeah, the white people have been sieved out, and the real people that are really giving real brands, real culture are just going.
Yeah.
And the people
are
also...
Because I feel like between like 2012 or whenever I started and now, like that's when everyone felt like they could just come up and bring all their crazy ideas. But then by now, everyone is realizing like who is really doing what they really want to do. Yeah, like only the real are surviving right now. Yeah. So... Yeah, I mean, big up to you for doing your thing, surviving.
Where can people follow you, you know?
Check me out on my social media, Bonkerz Kenya, on Instagram, Bonkerz Kenya on Facebook, Bonkerz Kenya on Twitter. And my personal account is Mvo the Jeweler.
Bonkerz with a Z.
King Customs, man. Thanks for coming through, man.
For sure, man. Mud love for what's good.
We gotta have you come through again.
Again, sure. Definitely. I mean, for a roast this
when
time.
They're not here.
You guys had me worried, man.
This guy comes in the studio.
So
you know, he comes in here. He was like, bro, I didn't know it was a roast today.
Man, no, dude.
He's like, it's not, bro.
They had me so worried.
He literally walked in and
I'm
like, are you ready for the roast?
Oh my god.
And he's like, Barack,
oh my
god. Like, Barack got me up here blindsided. Hello.
Straight up.
Next time it's gonna be a roast.
I'm ready now.
Be ready.
We're just giving you, you know.
I'm gonna write down.
I don't like these girls.
But I'll get you guys some stuff.
Okay,
but
definitely.
Let us know, man. Hey, appreciate it. Once again, thank you for coming through. Keep it locked to the Midnight Hump Show. Coming up next, we got the Party Cam Boys letting you know what's popping in the city. It's the Midnight Hump Show. Kama kawa, rapping kwenye campus, man. This is USIU Campus Choice Awards, and man, it's lit already.
About the event so far?
You?
Guys, I didn't see that one coming. I did not see that one coming.
Oh yeah, walk long, good fam.
my name is Barack Jacuzzi. Right now we are backstage at Campus Choice Awards going down to USIU 2016. I'm here with Miss USIU 2016, Calvin. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing a lot better now, you know, a lot better. So, how is the Campus Choice Awards going for you so far?
Wonderful. I love it.
Hey, you're a little late on the thing, but it's all good. We back at it, and this is the Party Cam. Right now, we have a segment guest, Raphael from Mandrill Entertainment. Yeah. Now, for those who don't, Roger Kuzi, Uncle Master.
Charlie Slim, Party Cam Squad.
Eleanor Nalima, yo.
Raphael.
Yeah.
From Mandrill Entertainment. And of course, we have Chelsea Vancart on the decks. Now, for those who don't know, before we get into the, you know, Party Cam and all of that, you know, how was the weekend, guys? You know? Was it lit or not?
The weekend is always lit, man.
We're always lit.
We checked out Alamod by Eledev, Suraj at the Alchemist, and it was lit, man.
It was a vibe.
Yeah. And this week is gonna be lit more.
What you got coming up? What's on the plan?
We have an event coming up on Thursday. It's called Trivia Nights on Thursday at Valiakid Mall, the previous Ozone, but it's owned it's called Hurricane now.
Thursdays.
So, yeah, so we have our event. We're bringing in big offers.
How much are the shots?
50.
We are back in Hurricane.
Major key.
You have to come to.
They brought back the 50-pound shots.
Is, we've reduced everything, like from shots, from beers, from wine glasses. You know, we've reduced everything. So our event is actually gonna be lit.
Word, man. Who's hosting? Y'all need to holler at the Coco Master. We get it popped.
We're the ones hosting it.
Oh, word. Yeah. All right.
We're bringing in DJ Ace. I think 2 weeks ago
Byron.
Yeah. 2 weeks ago we had DJ Case on the decks. The other night we had Rajal Ray, Shema, Joe Kisela. Yeah, they came through.
And speaking of DJs, Chelsea.
Do you partner with some guy called Spencer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he hit me
He's my partner.
Oh, yeah, Spencer he hit me Coyette, up, but yeah. I couldn't make it.
Yeah, he couldn't make it today.
Bro, you need to holler at Chelsea, man. You know, she's on high demand now, man. She's on high demand.
Yeah, like we've gotten, like really good hype from, like, you know.
How long have y'all been doing the Thursday nights at Hurricane?
For about 2 months now.
Yeah. Good. It's been progress.
Yeah, it's been.
Thursday nights used to rock it.
Because you know, every time we hold an event, we have different themes. Mm-hmm. Like we had the Fraternity Fridays where you come in, pay $500, and you get 2 free beers or 2 free drinks, whatever you want. And every night we have a different theme. So this Thursday we have a theme for 50 bob shots, 150 for a wine glass, 200 only. For beers, yeah,
and good prices. Now, you look like you like 19. How did you even get in? Well, how old are you, man?
21.
Okay, 21. Yeah. You legal to drink in America?
Yeah.
So, definitely. How did you get into party promoting, party organizing?
You know, it's actually one. It's like just some time back, we were sitting back in Spencer's house, and we were like, yo, you know, because you know Spencer's a young DJ. He's only 19, and we were like, this guy doesn't get many chances. So why don't we provide chances for other DJs who don't get them?
Heck yeah, if you got no juice, make your own.
Yeah.
No juice.
So, I mean, based on like what you've said, are you giving other undiscovered DJs opportunities? Because as far as I'm concerned, like you've named Rajal Ray, Joe Kisela, like Suraj, like these are already people who have such a big platform to perform.
You see, for Rajal Ray, DJ Case, those guys, we only bring them in for hype only. Like, we'd say, like, obviously, if you had Rajal Ray playing, you'd still come for the event just because Rajal Ray is there. So we usually have about 5-6 DJs on the decks for that night. But we put just the one big DJ. Like those DJs, the DJs I mentioned are just like for different nights.
Yeah, I dig it.
But we bring in different DJs, like underground DJs who.
I can vouch for him because I was telling you I was asked to do it, but I was in the country at the time. Yeah, and they had Sichangi also the other night.
Yeah, we had Sichangi.
So they putting on for the youngest.
Yeah,
that's what's up. That's what's up, man. You gotta build your team. You know, that's how you do it, man.
Because you know, we also want the club to grow up with the people around it.
Sure.
So if you're 19 now, 2 years later you'll be there. You're like 21.
Season vet.
Like,
you know what I mean?
No, let's go to Hurricane. Let's go hype it up.
I feel you, man. So,
understand, event organizer. What's the one thing that pisses you the most when it comes to organizing events? Maybe not your events. What do you see that it's just off?
When your event is hyped up on social media, but it actually doesn't.
I've seen a meme like the girls that you see advertising events plus the girls you meet at the event.
Yeah,
don't wanna go.
It's crazy. That's so cute, man. Speaking of events, I think it's time that we let the people know what's popping in Nairobi City.
Yo, man, there's a lot of things popping, man. We've been hyping Nyege Nyege Festival. Mm-hmm. And for the Kenyan fans who are asking what Nyege Nyege means, we told you, it's an urge to dance. To dance. Wachana na Nyege Nyege ya wa Kenya. So Nyege Nyege is coming next month, coming up on 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. It's a festival. When you see 50K, it's not Kenyan money. I guess that's 50K Ugandan shillings. Yeah, so it's cheap.
So how much is that in shillings? Kenyan shillings?
I think that's like...
This 50K is like 3Gs or
4Gs. No, not 4G.
Like
these?
I think it's like
conversion people, like 3K.
I ain't never been to Uganda.
We're gonna do our homework and come back next week.
Yeah, we'll let you know exactly what it is.
Yeah, but anyways, it features over 200 artists from over 30 countries.
I see.
2 mega stages, 3 days non-stop. What's Good Live will be there, so come through, man. It's gonna be a good time. How's your?
It's gonna be a wave.
Uh-huh. It's gonna be a wave. And speaking of waves,
oh my goodness.
Speaking of waves, you wanna tell them what
about it? What a great segue. The EA Wave and Friends. They're having an event, the EA Wave, some of Kenya's best collective DJ group. They're having an event on the 26th of August. That is next Friday?
Next
Friday at the Alchemist. The gate is only 1,000 bob, and there's going to be performances, and well, advanced tickets are 800, but there's going to be performances from some of the best entertainers in the city. Blinky Bill, Siraj, Yellow Light Machine, Barack Jacuzzi.
Who is Barack Jacuzzi?
I love that guy.
I'm a fan.
We got the Cosmic Homies, Ski Music, Charlie Slim.
It's gonna be a good one.
I was looking at the list and I'm like, Barack Jacuzzi.
Barack Jacuzzi.
That's why he's hyping it up.
It's a wave. It's a wave, man. It's a wave. But nah, seriously, it's gonna be quite the event. Make sure you're there. And if you're not, you're gonna watch it and be like, damn, I didn't listen.
I'm sad.
You know, so don't play yourself.
And speaking of Wednesdays, you know what other Wednesdays goes down each and every Wednesday at the Alchemist Bar. I think it's free entry for this night.
Free entry, yep.
Yeah, come through. It's
come through,
be some
get Iris, very good vibes, you know, chill vibes, great reggae music, and great spirits.
Yeah, plus get to experience the boombox, their own sound that they made. So come through, also. And I think that's it. Where can you catch guys even this weekend? You already told where we'll be.
Yeah, Chelsea.
Let Chelsea tell us.
This weekend.
Where are you usually
tonight or anywhere?
I don't know if this is really for party calendar, but like this week, you know Green Spots?
Yeah.
They're having the tournament like the whole week, so I'll be playing, I think, tomorrow.
Okay.
So yeah, you can come through. It's like the whole day, I guess.
Word. I'm going to be there as well. I'm going to be emceeing that event as well. So y'all can catch me.
So come through, support Chelsea, and support Barack Jacuzzi.
More juice.
No, but
when is it ending? On Saturday?
It ends on Saturday.
Yeah, I think the final.
Yeah, it ends on Saturday.
I've seen almost every guy. A lot of great. What's Good Live has the band. I'm like,
yeah.
Based on the Green Spots thing, is this also the one that's in UG or in Tanzania or something? Or is this just
the Kenyan one?
Kenyan. Yeah, but they got teams, over 150 teams, like people from all over the continent.
I just remembered, Spencer's gonna DJ there on Thursday.
Word.
Shout out to George Ouma.
So it's a popping week. It's a popping week for Nairobi and Kenya in general.
No, it's
always
like,
is.
You know, people think that I usually vouch for him just because like he's my boy or because I work with him, but be for real, if I hate you as a DJ, like if I don't like your music, I'll just come straight up and I'll tell you, No, I don't like your music.
I mean,
so,
you have to recognize.
But real, recognize
like,
real. Yeah, you know
like,
what I mean?
Personally, like, I've known Chelsea for such a long time, and she's always been like such a good DJ in my perspective. But like, people always feel like I also vouch for her because we're such good friends.
Man, to be honest, you should. Like, you should. If that's your
real,
homie,
real recognize real.
If that's your homie and they decent, go ahead and hype them up, man.
Real recognize real.
You can have the sauce, but
Even if you are my homie, if you're a bad DJ, I won't vouch for you. As long as you can get the crowd hyped, as long as the people like your music, then yeah, we're good to go.
Hey, and that's all we need, because you know you can have the sauce, but never get lost.
All
right?
Don't get lost in the sauce.
But anyways, if anyone wants to catch this and more, go make sure you go to WG Networks on the event section. And you'll find more juice over there, Usil.
A lot. You can drown in it. Keep it locked. This is the Midnight Hump Show, and we are the party cam. You know what I mean? We always let you know where it's at.
I was still banging.
You can do what you want. Yeah.
I'm Louis Kalinga. Yeah, today we're at the Commonwealth Center on Moy Avenue for the FIFA 16 Soccer E-Play Cup. Two commentators, 128 players, 34 stations, only 16 guys going through. Tune in, you guys. It's going to be an interesting one.
So the event is running in our shop. It's running in Trick Gaming Cafe, and we were in charge of, you know, preparing the whole facility to make sure everything was good. The consoles were updated, running properly. All the pads were properly configured for the tournament.
So, Halid Abdi, how are you feeling about the tournament today? Did you enjoy?
Well, it's not that bad. I started off very bad, but with time, with games, more games, then I improved. But like it was hard.
It's still the group stage still. How many games have you played?
Played, I think, five. I've won three, lost two. The first two, actually.
So you're still in contention to progress from the group stages, huh?
If all things go well, yeah. Inshallah. Okay.
Gaming is actually quite interactive sports for everyone to come together and have fun. So many matches going on. We're going to be covering the group stage this time and next weekend on the 21st. The final is on the 31st at the Kenya National Theatre. Watch Mchezo Crew, like he told you, the ultimate online sports show is going to be here with you throughout it all.
We're back.
We back
at it again.
So very well, Chelsea.
Thank you.
Said so very well, you know. Chelsea, you seem like a woman of few words. Is it just today or?
No, I'm like that.
Ask oh, yeah?
They've known me for long.
That's
Chelsea.
Yeah. Right, you have to force so much.
So how do y'all know? How do y'all know when she's mad and stuff? She don't really
talk. Oh, you're gonna know when I'm mad. Trust me.
You'll know when Chelsea's mad. Like, cause you'll be texting her. You're like, Chelsea, talk to me. She's just reading your text. Like,
I'll just tick you one time.
I don't think so.
And you know, I had fun with you guys today. You know, I'm ready for you guys now. I have my hater blockers on. That's what I like to call these glasses. Hater blockers.
Shade or no shade.
Hater blockers is what they're called.
Just know you will never be.
You'll
ready
never be
for
ready.
Us.
You never know what's coming for you,
you'll
boy.
You never know.
You ain't never
you
ready.
Never know.
I couldn't even hear you guys. The hater blockers. What did you say?
Okay.
No, I really did have a good time with you guys. Now, if these guys want to follow you guys, I don't know why they would. If you guys happen to, you know, overdose and want to follow somebody, these are the two. Where can they follow you guys?
On Instagram, you can find me at Rihanna.
Rihanna?
Everyone says that. No, Rihanna.
Rihanna.
Yes.
It's kind of like Keanu, but Rihanna?
Rihanna. Okay, have you heard, have you listened to Fleetwood Mac?
It's a really old country song.
Band, like, yeah.
And I fell in love with the song and I'm like, oh my God, I love this name so much. And I searched the name.
You want to sing it? I just want to know. I just, I'm just trying to hear the song.
I can play it for you. Let's go, Nadia. Nope. Moving on. New.
Hey, where can they follow
you? Okay, y'all can follow me on Instagram at Nali. That's GNARELLY. Nali.
And Chelsea.
Instagram, Chelsea Van Carter. If you want to add me on Snapchat, The Van Carter. If you want to add me on Facebook,
hey.
Chelsea Van Carter.
This is the most you talk the whole show.
The whole show.
You just, I didn't even know you had that
She's
in
like,
you.
She's like, social media, let's get it.
Let's do it. Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram.
Chelsea Van Carter. Is Van Carter your last name?
Barack Jacuzzi, is that your...
You did right. Oh, you did right. Okay.
Names.
I was conceived in a jacuzzi. All right, and that's how it came about.
Don't make your mom look like that. Come
on. Hey, what you mean? That's classy. That's classy. It's a home jacuzzi.
Okay, jacuzzi.
Hey, man. Home jacuzzi. I didn't know it's gonna have to be like you guys. I do not like y'all right now. Man, this was the Midnight Hump Show. I really did have a good time with you guys, despite my hater blockers, you know. I really did.
So did we. The next time is gonna be.
Nah, next time. No, next time y'all come, I'm getting so much dirt on y'all.
Not possible.
I'll help you. Trust me. I'm gonna help him.
Don't forget the picture.
I'm coming for blood.
You know, I'm not ashamed of my past, so you can do whatever.
Yeah, you are.
I'm coming for blood, and I'm gonna pull up a picture like Nadia. Tell me about this sixth grade blemish. When did that go away?
Come on up.
I got you. I got you.
Always ready.
I got you. And if you guys want to follow us and, you know, keep up with what's happening and what's good, make sure to follow us at WGNetworks.tv. That's the motherboard where you'll find What's Good Live. You'll find What's Good FM. We have shows every day. So many different things happening. And, of course, you can follow us on Twitter at What's Good Live. On Snapchat at...
Nali?
No, oh, What's Good Live.
You guys,
we had one job. Sorry. One job. Come on, guys.
I genuinely thought you were asking us.
Hey, man. And on Instagram at WGLive.tv. My name's Brad Jacuzzi, and this was episode 28 of season 2. There's only 2 episodes left in this season, so you're in for a surprise. Shout out to all the guests that came through. And well, not you guys, I meant everybody else.
Okay.
Keep it locked in the Midnight Hump Show. We out of here. Peace.
Bye.
Oh, yeah. Come on.